I'm Yasha de Nooyer and I'm an assistant professor at the Department of Health Promotion. And I teach in the Bachelor of Prevention in Health, and I also coordinate the Master of Health Education and Promotion. We wanted to learn students how to implement effective interventions. If you want to implement interventions, you should know what all the interests are of the people who are involved. We call that the stakeholders. So we want to learn students how to balance all the interests of the different stakeholders. And in the past, we let students go to real organizations and to talk to real people, but people have less time nowadays. So it was difficult to arrange that year after year. And that's why we thought about, why don't we create a world or a situation which is almost similar to the real world. It's called a virtual world and it looks like Second Life, where they can practice in a safe environment with the stakeholders, in interviewing them about factors that facilitate or inhibit implementation of such interventions. It's still in the development phase. Right now the virtual world is almost ready to implement in our educational system. There will be 35 students who will participate, but we also cooperate with the School of Midwifery here at the compound, and they are also going to use our virtual city with all the healthcare organizations for their educational activities. So there are more students who are going to benefit from this virtual world, and they are also going to do the same assignment. But it would also be possible for other students or for other departments to use this virtual environment for other projects. Well, I think it is a very innovative way of problem-based learning, because you work with real-life problems, which is one of the things of problem-based learning. They have to collaborate. They construct on what they already learned. They build up knowledge on what they learned in previous courses. So I think it's another way of doing problem-based learning in a nice environment, which is a bit excited for students also. I hope that it will be a success, of course, and especially the technical part, because that's what is out of my control. I can provide the content, and I'm sure that we are with a nice team of teachers and they're all involved in this project, and so the content is okay, but the technical part is something we don't have in our own hands, so that's difficult, and I hope that we will be able to do a nice project.